Good morning, everyone. Today we'll discuss how to read newspaper for the UPSC Civil Services exam. As you know, current affairs forms a very important part of both prelims as well as mains. So one needs to be on his toes when it comes to current affairs. You need to cover the current affairs of the entire year, and that too thoroughly, so that you know you do not miss out on any of the questions, be it the prelims exams or the mains exam. Now for current affairs, the first and the foremost thing that the students have, the doubt that is there in their mind is which newspaper to refer to. So as such, there is no, strict thing that, you should only read the Hindu or you should only read the Times of India or the Indian Express. But yes, the two standard papers are Hindu and the Indian Express. You can choose any one of them. If you can read two of them on a daily basis, that is great. But at least choose one of them. Hindu or Indian Express would do. Now, before starting with the preparation of your current affairs, one thing should be made very clear. Before starting reading the newspaper, you should have an in-depth understanding of what the syllabus of the civil services exam is. So, you keep the syllabus always in handy. Look at the topics that are mentioned in the syllabus, both in prelims as well as mains, and then see what are the current affairs that could pertain to those topics. Always try to look out for the news items in the newspaper, which correspond to the topics that are mentioned in the syllabus. That becomes very important. So once you start doing it, which, initially it will probably take you some time. You should be spending somewhere around 3.5 or 4 hours reading the newspaper. Subsequently, the time will come down as your habit develops, as you start reading on a regular basis. So the time would become less, right? So let us see, first we'll discuss what to read in the newspaper, and then in a very small way, in a very, very succinct way, I will discuss how to read the newspaper, right? So let's start with what and end with how. So the first thing is, which news to read? What do you need to read in the newspaper? So, as you know, in civil services exams, there are various broad topics. For example, polity and governance is one, economy is another, environment and ecology is the third, international relations is there. So, all these topics, you need to cover the current affair for these topics. So, for example, when I talk about the polity segment of the exam or the polity subject for the civil services exam, which is GS paper 2 as well as a good part of your prelim syllabus, always look out for news, which are related to the government schemes. The recent bills that have been passed in the parliament, the important bills you should be knowing. So what are the important bills that are passed in the parliament? The schemes, like I mentioned, you should know about the schemes that currently are running. How those schemes are doing, you should know that. Important judgments given by the Supreme Court. That becomes very important. In fact, UPSC of late has been focusing a lot on Supreme Court verdicts and important judgments. You should be thorough with that. Right. So any other news related to, for example, a major constitutional amendment, you should be thorough with it. You should read that news. When it comes to elections, you don't need to cover which party had how many votes, with how much margin did BJP or Aam Aadmi Party win or lose. No, those kind of things you don't need to study or read. But always look out for election reforms related news. Right, Representation of People Act, it is there in your main syllabus, and in fact elections, they are the bulwark of our democracy. So you should know the news related to the reforms the Election Commission have bought, any new changes that have been bought, what has been banned and what has been allowed in the elections. So that basically becomes very important to read. Apart from that, always look out for some good parliamentary debates if they are there in the news, because what would happen is, if you read those debates, you will get an informed opinion. You will get both pros and cons of important legislations of bills. So that would result into an effective answer writing. So ensure that once you are covering the polity related news, all these news get covered. So that is the first thing. Second, after polity, you should be reading the international relation news. That is very, very important. For example, whenever our prime minister or our president visits any country, what are the treaties that have been signed? What are the bilateral arrangements that they have made? So, and what is the impact of those treaties, those arrangements on India as well as the world? Those are the points that you need to read. Those are the points that you need to be thorough with, so that you can write a well-informed answer in mains. Definitely, that is one thing that you need to do. Second thing, when we talk about international relations, there are multilateral agencies. For example, agencies of the UNO, WTO, IMF. So news related to all these agencies, you must be thorough with. What are the recent happenings in these agencies? What are the recent decisions taken? Again, what are the recent agreements that have been done? The impact of those decisions on India as well as India's neighbors. These are the kind of things that you need to look out for. These are the kind of things that you should be reading in the newspaper under the international relation heading. So that is the second thing. Then we come on to the environment and ecology part. So students find it very tricky about what to read in environment, what not to read. Although there is no, everybody knows there is no fixed scope for this subject. But when it comes to environment and ecology, ensure that you are reading news, you know, where they have discussed about some endangered species. So because IUCN red data book and all those we anyways read for the exam. So ensure that any news related to the endangered species you are thorough with. Any new environmental legislation that has come up, you must know that. So if a bill has been passed in parliament pertaining to environment and ecology, you know, National Green Tribunal judgments, all those things you should be thorough with. Also important events related to environment and ecology, for example, if any new national park has come up or some status changes there with regards to any of the national parks, that you should know. Important things like tiger population and this would fall under the endangered species, but yes, so all those things, these you should thoroughly cover under the environment and ecology part. Also, other news related to floods, disaster management, these would also somewhere come fall under the environment and ecology part, and you should be thorough with, along with the legislations or agreements related to these news. Fourth, under the environment and ecology part, you should read about the conventions. If any of the convention is there in news, make sure not only you read that news, but also the history of that convention. Various conventions, for example, could be Ramsar Convention on wetlands. So you, once it is there in the news, you should be knowing the history of that convention as well as what the current news about that convention is. So that becomes very important, right? So this is about the environment and ecology. Next is economy. So for economy, you need to be first very thorough with the fundamentals. Once you're done with the static book, whatever book you may be referring to, NCERT or others or your class notes, you must be thorough with the concept. Now, once you are thorough with the concept, economy related news becomes a cakewalk to cover because it is all conceptual. So you should read news related to inflation. You should read news related to various indicators like IIP or GDP of the country. How is it moving up or down? All those news would fall under the economy part. Along with that, you should read news related to any of the legislations, or I might say any new reports which have come up on behalf of the RBI or on behalf of Niti Aayog or on behalf of SEBI, right? So all those news, they become very important, right? And these are very, very essential for mains as well as prelims. And most important under the economy part, apart from the newspaper reading, is the economic survey and the budget. You should be thorough with economic survey and budget, especially both for prelims and for mains, because we see direct questions in prelims for those, and the points from economic survey can be used in your answer writing for mains, which will give you a very high score. So ensure that you are reading economy related news on a daily basis, and you are covering all the news that we are discussing right now. I'm just giving you a brief gist. There might be more news, but make sure that these are the important news, the important headings you are always covering. Then comes, you know, the general knowledge kind of news, which you should be reading. So there is, again, no fixed scope for these news. For example, a new IVC, Indus Valley Civilization site, has been discovered. You should know about that because a question directly might come in prelims, or you can use that same question for the art and culture section in your mains GS paper 1. So that kind of news you should know. Any news related to the societal issues, for example, migration of the human population. In fact, there was a news recently that why more and more people are migrating to Delhi and Bombay for work. So those kind of news, they can become very handy when you are writing answers to the society related questions for GS paper 1. So society related news, like I said earlier, we discussed about the news which related to history, art and culture, which are there. So there is a plethora of news when it comes to art and culture. You know, you would see new sites, new dance forms, you would see tribes, you would see news related to new tribes. All those things you should cover under the general knowledge section. In fact, science and technology related news also would fall under this section. So this is done for the general knowledge section. Now, once you're reading all this news, always keep a keen eye, like I said, and correspond these news items to the syllabus, the topics mentioned in the syllabus. For example, in economy section, if you are reading news related to some report on the Indian railways, that how to make railways more efficient, or let's say the bullet trains, so you should know that this news falls under the general studies paper 3 section of mains. Mark that news wherever you are making your notes, be it the soft copy or the hard copy. Mark that topic right in front of that this is the GS paper 3 news, right? And it falls under the railway topic that is mentioned in the syllabus, so that you have a set category of each and every news that you read. Once you have a set category of each and every news that you read, it will become very, very easy for you to revise that. Right. So ensure that whatever news you are reading, you are correlating that to the topic mentioned in the syllabus. And once that is done, you will have different categorizations, like I said, and it would become very, very easy for you to revise those news, because once you are reading the topics according to the syllabus for your mains or prelims, you would directly know that this is the current affair that I need to focus on related to this topic. Right. So now let us come to, we've talked about what to read. Now let's talk about what not to read also. So any, sports related news, for example, about the Cricket World Cup or about FIFA, those news are not important for UPSC civil service exam. One should know out of, if you have a hobby of, you've mentioned your hobby as cricket in DAF or soccer in DAF, you should definitely know about these things. But the probability of getting questions from these sections of the current affair is the least when it comes to the civil services exam. Also, second thing is, do not focus on news related to any election, any political party. These are the achievements of this political party. They have made this free for certain section of the population, because political party related news is seldom asked in the UPSC examination. Thirdly, you do not need to know about how many seats did any political party win or lose, because those factual election related information, they would not be asked. Right. So UPSC would never dwell deep into that. So that kind of news you do not need to read. You also do not need to read any entertainment related news regarding movies or TV shows. That is the least important when it comes to UPSC examination. So you don't need to cover those things. Also, now when we talk about what to read and what not to read, the last thing I also want to put some stress on is how to read the news. For example, let's say we've talked about, you should read about the bilateral trade treaties that have been, formed between India and XYZ country where the president or the prime minister visited. Now, once you're reading that news, it becomes important to understand the concept of that news rather than, reading or remembering the figures. You do not need to know that between India and China, XYZ agreement was made under this agreement. XYZ crores amount or XYZ USD would be given to India, or India would give that amount to some country. You do not need to remember the facts as such. You need to remember the crux or the concept of that news, that why this treaty or agreement has been made, what is the consequence of that agreement, and what are the pros and cons of that benefit. So that is what you need to read. Also, when we talk about various agencies like WTO or IMF, you do not need to know the amount of the loan that these agencies have given to XYZ country or to India, right? So you do not need to know that. You need to know that which are the sectors these agencies are catering to, right? So if an agreement has been made, what is the concept of that agreement? What good would that agreement do in a particular country, be it India or be it its neighbor? So these are the kind of things that you need to focus on. Again, when we talk about the polity related news, if you are reading about some bill, you do not need to know the date when that bill was introduced in Lok Sabha, when was it transferred to Rajya Sabha. Those kind of factual information is not required. You also do not need to know that under this bill, once the bill gets passed, Union government will give XYZ amount to a particular state. Again, no need for any facts and figures, just the concept. You should be thorough with the concept. Factual information is seldom asked, definitely will not be asked in mains. In prelims also, 99% of the times, nobody will ask you about the amount or the date or XYZ funding. Nobody is going to ask you about that. So everything should be concept based. So that is very important. Apart from these, apart from covering current affairs through newspaper, I told you one should definitely cover economic survey and budget. apart from that, you should definitely read the reports from agencies like Niti Aayog. They've become very important, because the recommendations of these reports, they are extremely important for the economy, for the country, and that is why the value of this news is very high. You can use these points in all across all your papers, be it GS2, be it GS3, in fact, even for ethics paper, GS4. So these kind of news or these kind of reports, they become very important. So these reports are there. Also, you should follow, some good channel. For example, the Rajya Sabha TV. The debates that come on Rajya Sabha TV become very important. Once you start watching those debates, you would form a very informed opinion about things, about topics, be it topics like GMO or be it topics like the recent Article 370, right? So these kind of debates will help you form an informed decision. So you should definitely watch one of those channels like Rajya Sabha TV to cover your current affairs holistically. Now again, let me give you a very small example of when I say what to focus upon in a news. Let us take a very current example of revocation of Article 370, right? So if a question comes in UPSC about Article 370, the question would not be about when was Article 370 revoked, right, or when was Article 370 brought into place. But the question would they would also not ask about whether BJP was good in revoking Article 370, or was Pandit Nehru, he was right when Article 370 was revoked. No, it is a very controversial kind of a topic also. So UPSC would not ask that. Instead, the question that can come on Article 370 is about the brief history that Article 370 has been in place for so many years in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, and recently it was revoked. Do you think that revocation of Article 370 can bring peace and prosperity to the valley or Jammu and Kashmir as a whole? So these are the kind of questions that would be asked. So you should be aware about the history of Article 370. Is revocation of Article 370 good? Give the pros and cons that revoking Article 370, these points are, they can be considered as pros for the revocation, and XYZ, mention 5 points that these points they still need to be catered to, because after revocation of Article 370, these are the points that the problem country or state of J&K can face the problem as a whole, and finally give a appropriate solution of the way forward, that these are the solutions how these problems can be dealt with, and take a stand finally, right? So this is how one needs to cover current affairs. So what to read, what not to read, and how to read. We have covered all those things in details, and we hope that you learn something from this, and you are able to cover your current affairs in a proper way. Also, on our website neostencil.com, we have a current affairs section for you exclusively, where we discuss the current affairs of the entire day, so that and that is a compilation of all the news related articles from different websites, so that you do not have to sift your way through every day on various websites or newspapers. You can go through that, you can find the important news, and you can start reading on. Thank you so much for your time, and have a great day.